Hello everybody, NitzaGamer here, and it's about friggin' time I got this third test build ready. The best answer on why this took so long is procrastination, and a lot of work, and I was trying so hard to keep active on uploads for the sake of your guys' entertainment and whatever. So without further ado, let's see the first thing that has changed for the Sonic prototype. Remember that boring title screen in the last two builds? Yeah. Pretty lame. Well, with the power of plugins and coding, I was able to turn a map into a title screen. That's better. And there's an option to close the game straight from the title screen. Now, as for actual changes themselves, there's not a lot to see, but there's definitely a lot to explore. While I have changed a few things on the main map, most of it is the same and the Minotaur quest you guys might have completed in the last build is still intact. However, the big difference in this test build is that there's a few more maps than before. If you go down this path, you can find an early alpha version of the city square. The reason I say alpha is because this will become an actual area I intend to have in the final game. It's still far off from what I envision, as I will replace all sprites and tile sets, as everything you see is default sets or placeholders. However, that's not all. There's also a new quest called the Chili Dog Quest, to which I won't give details on how to complete it, as I think it's more fun if you figure it out on your own. The other thing that has been added is food. You can buy food from the store, which is intended to replace the use of potions that you would see in your fantasy RPG. As of now in this test build, almost all the food is not functional, and probably won't be until I've worked on battles and losing conditions that will make these items useful. However, items such as the mushroom, antidote, and emetic from the last build will have use in this current build. If you play this prototype deep enough, you can find out what I might possibly do with all this food in the game, as it will play a major part in the character's survival. And another test map that has been added is a library. Now, in the final game, I do intend to have a library, however, this version does not represent the vision of what I want the library to be. In fact, I want it to be a little messy looking. Instead, in this prototype, the Sonic Fan Club is being hosted. And this girl won't stop following me. Oh hey Rouge, what are you doing back here? Now, there's a lot more content that I added that I haven't mentioned, but this is most of the meat of what is added. It may not seem like a lot because, well, it isn't. However, everything added is intended for testing purposes and to find out how I can push the limits to bring the game I envision to life. And if you've explored this prototype to your heart's content, there is a secret debug menu which has been accessible since the second build and continues to be accessible here. I won't say how you can open the debug menu, but this menu can be used to mute the background music if it becomes too repetitive for you. It can also be used to teleport you to different locations and NPCs. You can even change your avatar's appearance, and you can use the option to enable you to walk through walls and on top of areas you're not intended to walk. You might even find a few strange things if you really go looking for them. And this secret menu can be used to check to see if you've completed the three main quests, and you can change the game's variables so you can complete two of the quests right away and speed up the progress of the Minotaur quest. Now, this debug menu is only accessible on three maps, and I would strongly recommend not using it until you've explored the entire prototype on foot. But it's there if you want to use it, and it's definitely been useful for me during playtesting and, well, finding bugs, as the reason why it's called debug. And that should be most of what's added in this build. The next build should hopefully expand on further aspects such as where speed comes into play, being a Sonic game and all, how the different commands are going to work, the various concepts that will give you a deeper, closer insight to what the final game could be like, as a lot of what's in these builds do not reflect what I actually want. In the end, I hope you guys are excited for more, and I can't wait till I get these aspects of the final game out for you guys to playtest. Thank you for watching the development of the unnamed Sonic fan game. This is NitzaGamer, hyped for Sonic Forces.